It is my favourite time of year and time to put the .NET hat on because it's time for .NET Conf 2025. Now, 1 year ago, all they could talk about was Aspire.
Aspire 9, .NET Aspire, .NET Aspire.
.NET Aspire, .NET Aspire, .NET Aspire, .NET Aspire.
.NET Aspire.
And then 6 months ago or so, we had .NET Conf focus on modernization, which was more like folks us on modernization.
Give folks an idea.
Folks ask. Some folks were asking questions. Some folks.
I want folks.
For folks. A lot of folks contribute. A lot of folks are worried.
Yay, folks!
So this year, I've gone in a little bit skeptical, expecting some total cringe. I think they've listened. I think they've actually listened because look at this.
I want as much of the snappy thing. I want one of those for the house. Did you, in fact, write ASP.NET MVC single-handedly on an airplane and then land and then hand it to people and say, here, I've written MVC?
No, not entirely.
Yes. We open with Scott Hanselman in his office. We open with a .NET MVC reference. Absolutely unbelievable. And I'm this has warmed the cockles of my cynical .NET boomer heart. I'm actually kind of excited. Because last year, it was opened by a guy that was at the Apple campus. I didn't know what was going on, okay? And who are these guys? Who are these guys? Not a clue. But let's go and do the analysis of this, okay? Because last year I did this. So Aspire, of course, is big news. They're still doing it. They've updated Aspire to Aspire 13. It is no longer .NET Aspire. And I think, well, they're going for gold here, going for broke. What's the worst that can happen if they can actually convince polyglot software engineers or software environments, in fact, places with a little bit of C#, a little bit of Go, to adopt Aspire as their infrastructure or orchestration system? I'll be very, very impressed, because Aspire was mentioned 42 times, 42 times in the keynote. Now, how does that compare to previous years? Yeah, because I am keeping track. I'm that sad. All right. So here are the scores on the doors for the last 4 years. All right. And as you can see, Aspire was 56 times last year. Okay. And this year we got 42 times. So a little bit fewer mentions of Aspire, but that's because they're focusing on Copilot. Yeah. Funnily enough, Copilot's mentions went up another 50% this year, but also C# has got a decent shoo-in. So this was a really good keynote by Scott Hanselman, I think, actually, like, good stuff, right? So let's visualize this, because we are that sad, okay? This is a chart from last year, and if we stick our new data on, it's really telling how the containers story has slowly dropped off. Blazor has had a bit of a renaissance. Last year, I was suggesting that Blazor might be on its last legs, but Blaze actually got a decent mention. And now obviously this is not scientific, okay? It's not scientific, but I think it gives a little bit of direction. And you can see like what they're focusing on. So obviously if we go back here, Aspire is okay. Now the big story here, of course, is .NET MAUI. MAUI was only mentioned four times in the keynote compared to 30 something times last year. Now people are saying to me, "Don't MAUI's not dead, Ed. You are just a hater." Well, I'm sorry. I'm looking at the data. Okay, read into it what you will. All right. So Blaze was mentioned 17 times, but the big story is that they said "folks" zero times during this keynote. Zero times. I think this is incredible, absolutely incredible, because if you remember from the last time they did this, it was absolutely insane. Aspire is their big thing this year, and I'm going to give them benefit of the doubt. Right. I hope they do well and they're making good effort. I still would put C# first, not Java first. I mean, come on, give us a break. But maybe it's not even in alphabetical order. So there's no, maybe if you refresh, it does a different order every time. No, it doesn't. It's not like the browser picker thing. Aspire 13, good luck to the team. Although I do question the need to advertise Aspire by having the team do cooking or something, making things. What's this got to do with Aspire? Like building stuff out of food or something? Okay. But not as cringe as last year. Visual Studio 2026, of course, is now out. And it's a cracker of a release, guys. Okay, just don't run it on a potato virtual machine like I've been doing. It's a serious bit of kit. Okay, what do you think is up? What do you think is going to happen to .NET over the next year? Please, answers in the comments. I love your comments. I will respond to every single one. Thank you very much for watching.